Before you navigate through the content, we would like to explain our aims regarding this MOOC. As you already may know, this course will offer you an overview of theories, case studies, and practices, but we will not attempt to give you a recipe. Why not? Well, because we do not believe that complex challenges will be solved by copying and pasting successful solutions from a different context. We do believe that we need to think local and global, and that is why we encourage you to debate, reflect, and discuss what is the most appropriate approach to understand your context.
This doesn't mean that we have to invent the wheel over and over, but that if we want to learn from another country or apply our ideas in other places, we have to first understand the local situation and challenges to then think carefully how to tackle them. Hence, the purpose of the case studies that we will present is to illustrate these challenges and how different countries and different professionals have approached them. We would like you to think critically and not simply reproduce a given formula. And when we talk about thinking critically, we mean it. So please be critical even to the examples provided in this course.
Another point that we would like to explain is why do we use the term Global South? The concept of Global South emerged as an alternative way to refer to developing countries or the third world. The concept does not represent a literal geographical division between two hemispheres. It should be understood in the context of globalization as a group of countries that, to some extent, share similar political, economic, social, or environmental challenges.
Even though the concept is far from being perfect, it has been considered as a better alternative because it has less of a condescending meaning embedded on it. Some authors have even mentioned the empowerment aspect and the political weight implied in the definition. You can find some links in this section for articles about the debate on the terminology. We strongly believe that to rethink the city, we must care from the terminology we use to the way we critically analyze our urban policies. In that sense, we prepare the course not only to provide you with tools, but also to inspire you to rethink our cities.
Welcome and enjoy the course.